You have learned what the limit of a sequence is. You have learned the rules of the game. Let us apply the results to a few examples and compute some limits. Well, start with the sequence with elements n divided by n plus 1, n from 1 to infinity. What happens if n goes to infinity? Well, it seems a bit annoying because n goes to infinity and n plus 1 goes to infinity. So what can we do? If we take the limit, well, divide both numerator and denominator by n. That's possible because n is just an integer. Take the limit to infinity, but that means that n is still some integer. Then we get 1 over 1 plus n. Then we can apply the quotient rule. The limit of a quotient equals the quotient of the limits if they both exist and are non-zero. So quotient rule over here. Well, limit in the numerator is trivial, of course. For the denominator, we use the sum rule. Limit of a sum equals the sum of the limits over here. And then we have our limit, our familiar limits. Limit n to infinity of 1 is just 1, of course. And limit n to infinity of 1 over n equals 0, as we have shown before. So we get 1 over 1 equals 1. Next example. There we take, again, some infinity over infinity type of case. N over the square root of 10 plus n, n from 1 to infinity. So what happens if n becomes large? Now, take the limit of n to infinity of the an, and we divide by the highest power, which is n. So the numerator becomes 1. And in the denominator, we have 1 over n times the square root. If we want to take the 1 over n in, we have to take the square root of 1 over n squared. So what we end up with is 10 over n plus 1 over n squared. So what do we get in the denominator? Something which tends to 0 plus something which tends to 0. So the denominator becomes arbitrarily small. So we have a 1 divided by something which becomes arbitrarily small and is positive. So this whole limit goes to infinity. So this sequence is divergent. Limit does not exist. Then, next example. The ln of n divided by n for n to 1 to infinity. So what happens in the limit if n goes to infinity? Well, there again we have a problem because the logarithm is blowing up and the n is blowing up. And we would like to apply L'Hôpital's rule here, because we knew that would work for functions. But hey, wait a minute. If you have a sequence of numbers, you cannot apply L'Hôpital's rule, because it uses differentiability and the sequence is only defined at integer values. And differentiation is about something which is in the neighborhood of a point. So you cannot apply L'Hôpital's rule to sequences. But what you can do is you define the corresponding function first, fx equals ln of x over x. You compute the limit x to infinity of this fx. There you can use L'Hôpital's rule, so you get 1 over x divided by 1 equals 0. And then you apply our theorem that if the limit of the function exists, then the limit of the sequence exists and they are equal. Since we know the limit of our function exists, we know that since an are f at n, we know that the limit of the sequence also exists and equals 0. So this example is already a bit trickier because you have to pass over to the function first, because only there you can use L'Hôpital's rule. Don't use L'Hôpital's rule to sequences. It's really sloppy. And next example, minus 1 to the power n over n, n from 0, n from 1 to infinity. So what's happening now? This minus 1 to the power n makes a 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1, makes it an alternating sign. But 1 over n is making the elements very small. So without 1 over n, the sequence would be divergent. We have seen that already, because you get 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1. Maybe the 1 over n will help us. But how are we going to show that this is really going to converge? Well, we use the following trick. We can squeeze. This minus 1 to the power n equals either minus 1 or plus 1. So in particular, it is between minus 1 and 1. So if we divide this by n, we get minus 1 to the power n over n is between minus 1 over n and plus 1 over n. And why do we do that? Well, now we can use the squeeze rule. We set an equals minus 1 over n and cn 1 over n, and our real sequence bn is in between. And then we take the limits of infinity of a and n cn. Those are both trivial, those are both zero. And so we squeeze rbn in between the a and n cn. So the limit n to infinity bn also has to be equal to zero. So this sequence is convergent with limit equal to zero.